So Gilbert, did they want to continue that, or did we?
Just wanted to update the commission real quickly, just on what we submitted, and then, yeah, we'll have to go to the next meeting with it. We just had a site walk last week. Brad Holmes, Steve Ivas has reviewed the site as well. We made a number of revisions to the plan per that site walk in our last meeting. We've reduced the size of the foundation. We've pulled it back another 5 feet from the original proposal, so it's at 25 feet from the BVW line. We've cut the foundation in half so that half of it is on poured foundation, the other half is on sonotubes to allow for the passing of small invertebrate underneath the house itself. The septic system was approved by the Board of Health. We also submitted a mitigation plan and a written narrative to go along with it. We located all of the trees within the limit of work by size. The trees that we're taking down are in red. All the trees that are staying within the limit of work are shown in green. So there was request to verify, and I'm verifying that the two 40-inch trees on site are staying. We're not touching those. We've added a planting plan. This is a list of plants that Steve and Brad thought would be appropriate as mitigation. And we're also providing bird nesting boxes as well to provide habitat. There's a split rail fence along the limit of work to prevent any further encroachment into the resource area. And again, this limit of work is really an area that the house itself is primarily over a large ledge outcrop. And then as you'll see where we picked up existing trees, the remainder of the work for the driveway and for the garage is essentially devoid of any significant sized vegetation. We understand that due to the timelines, this will have to get continued, but I guess we were just seeking if there was any further comments from the site walk that anyone came up with, or if anyone wanted to.
Was she going to give us a foundation plan, Greg?
We can give you one, but what we did on this plan is we specified this here is the poured concrete foundation, plus there's two poured walls, one and two.
Okay.
And then the rest is all just sonotubes.
So are they just going to dowel those into the ledge?
Into the rebar.
So are you going to blast it all, or just?
No, just drill into the ledge that's there.
I think they're going to have to do something, though, to get water and.
The water and electric.
And gas and whatever.
Yeah, that all comes up the driveway into the poured part of the foundation, and that's where all the utilities will be.
So can they, is there a place to dig there, or do they have to blast to get that? Do you have any idea?
They'll have to do a little bit of chipping, probably with a hammer, just at the back of the garage. It's kind of a fractured rock in the back corner there. I don't see any need for blasting.
But to get the water line deep enough and stuff?
No, because the test pits that we did in the driveway all had 4 feet of soil over them.
Okay.
So there won't be any blasting.
Okay.
So that's the update for 36th Border.
And I don't think that the applicant had any problems with the new mitigation plan and the idea of not stripping the area, but going in and doing individual plantings. I think she was very much in favor of that.
Yeah, it's all to be done by hand, all of the mitigation plans.
And that has, like, you're going to remove the...
The invasives.
That's on there, too, I'm sure.
Yeah, there's the... I submitted a written narrative that describes the steps that will be taken for that.
Correct.
I think this is the first property I've seen where mitigating and planting in the buffer with actual removing of invasives will help the area. And I mean, I think it'll really help those existing tupelo that are there live. And they're not right now because, well, they are, but they're going to die soon. Yeah, because of the vines and...
You know, and I think the other thing that really differentiates this site is the location of the house. is over a large piece of impervious surface that's already out there.
Right.
As opposed to having to remove significant vegetation for the house location.
Steve had suggested that somebody be there when you were cutting.
A botanist.
Yeah. And that would have to be at the owner's expense, it seemed to me. And I would assume that it sounded as though she was amenable to that.
He suggested that there actually be someone on site.
Yeah, because of the nature of the vegetation out there, the cutting.
Cutting for the.
There's no way to have all the trees on that plan that you've got there.
Right, so all of these trees will be marked by a botanist, and then all of this work in here will be directly observed by a botanist, is what we're saying.
Right.
And on site for that.
It seemed like an awfully good idea.
Yeah, and I think if you're open to that, we'd accept a condition, you know, requiring a botanist be on site or an arborist be on site for the clearing. That'd be fine.
I'm guessing you guys will have a lot of this marked out too, so there can be a pre-construction meeting and all of that where it'll
Absolutely.
Be visualized in the field.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I guess if it can be marked and it's okay, just think there ought to be some sort of time limit on that. You know, I mean, I wouldn't want to.
Oh, on how many hours the person has to be there.
Needs to be there or whatever, so that.
I mean, the initial clearing here isn't gonna be any more than a day.
Right.
Taking the trees down, and then this part back here will be done at a separate time, and you're gonna want the botanist there to do the plantings themselves. So.
I didn't see any issue with the front side. It was the back side that mm-hmm. I thought was.
Except for the large trees and stuff, but that's out of it.
Yeah. That's fine. I don't think there's a need for a time limit.
All right.
I really don't.
Okay.
Good. So, make a motion to continue it until.
Yeah, who's got the.
I don't think the one's there.
Sorry, we don't have a secretary. We can't.
I don't know. That's
no, we can. No, no,
we can't continue any of these.
17th is the next meeting, and then we're in January.
Like bird nesting 9th. Boxes. What are you actually going to put there? I know there's like a few different kinds in here, but there's like wood duck, bluebird. I was just wondering if you'd.
Yeah. You're going to have wood duck.
I don't know if he says which ones in particular.
Isn't it nice she handed it to you?
I don't have a pencil.
I don't either.
Can't do it in pen.
It says there's going to be 6. I was just wondering if you'd talked about it at all. It's no big deal. It's just.
No, I mean, he provides 3 different types.
Yep.
Right.
So I'd probably say 2 of each.
Right.
Steve had suggested, and I don't know whether they're in your proposal, maybe some bat.
You got a pencil?
Boxes, maybe.
Okay. That'll work.
See, it's a shop. Is there anything left there?
We could certainly have that.
Yeah.
There's no water. No wood duck.
They live in trees.
No, right.
I'll ask Brad and Steve about that.
Yeah.
So we're just going to the next meeting?
Yeah, December 17th. We're just waiting for a pencil.
Do you want a pen?
No, because if we, you never know. Penny might not like it if we use a pen in here. All right, so
Penny won't be back.
I'll make a motion to continue Gilbert 36 Border Street to December 17th at 7 p.m.
A second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you. Anthony, Thomas Clap Road, New Bell. On December 3rd, 2012, 6:40 p.m., the Town Hall, Scituate Conservation Commission will hold a wetlands hearing under Chapter 131, Section 40 of the Massachusetts General Laws and Section 30700 Town Citro Code of Bylaws regarding the application of Justin E. Anthony to construct a new dwelling on property located at Thomas Clapp Road, 17-3-13, Scituate. There's another interested parties in.
Record, Greg Morse, Representative of Justin Anthony, the applicant. We're here for a notice of intent associated with a new single-family home. This is located on Thomas Clapp Road between Itchy's Corner and the Norwell Town Line. This is on the northern side of Clapp Road, directly opposite of Highland Crossing. This property is 3.29 acres. The bold line represents the property line. Thomas Clapp Road is to the south. The wetlands that we have on site, there's a bordering vegetated wetland. This was delineated by John Zimmer, South River Environmental, April of this year. There's also an isolated wetland pocket, the southern portion of the site. All of our proposed work, you'll see, is at the southwestern corner. This is the area where we're proposing the house. So sheet one zooms in on that area. In total, the site has 99,000 square feet of upland. There is no certified, there are no certified vernal pools on the site. The green line here represents the 100-foot buffer. The red line represents the 50-foot buffer, and the blue line represents that BVW line and the isolated line. Okay. All of the work here is located outside of the 50-foot. We're proposing a new driveway from Thomas Clapp Road coming into a new single-family house. This house is served by a septic system. The septic system is located entirely outside the 100-foot buffer zone. The reserve area is also located outside of the buffer zone. We have water and electric service out to Thomas Clapp Road. For drainage, what we are proposing, we're proposing a crushed stone infiltration trench along the side of the driveway, so sheet flow off the driveway will end up in this infiltration trench. We're also proposing tying the roof leaders into a series of dry wells. You'll see we have dry wells at the front corner of the garage, the front of the main building, and out behind the main building. So four individual sets of dry wells. We're also proposing a rain garden at the bottom of slope, at the bottom of the septic system area. So from the limit of work forward, this area, we're maintaining the existing drainage patterns right now. Thomas Clapp Road is at elevation 101. The wetlands at elevation 86, and the land gently slopes that way in the existing conditions. In the proposed conditions, we're maintaining that grade. We are flattening out the front yard, but again, all of the water traverses in the same northerly direction. The stormwater report we submitted showed that the pre versus post rates and volumes of runoff were maintained using these three mitigation procedures, the infiltration trench, the dry wells, and the rain garden. DEP had no comments. I'll turn it over to you.
Break it up and we'll start at the other side.
Okay. I don't have any questions.
Tony?
Has the wetland line been approved? Have we approved that?
Not through an ANRAD, no.
It just seems to me that this piece of property all drains down into the South Swamp, and I don't know whether it's a South Swamp, but it's a big area of
Cohasset would be more concerned with where this goes than us.
I guess that's probably right.
Aaron River Reservoir.
Yeah, yes. Right. But this piece of property is looks as though it's very important for water drainage and filtration. And it would seem to me that line should be approved.
Do you know, though, it seems to me like that might have been delineated before.
Was it? I don't know.
Prior to April of this year, I don't know if it had been delineated or not. Like I said, it was just done in April.
Just to save you, I mean, if there was somebody that had done it fairly recently and they were close, save you a...
I don't know of anyone else that's delineated it.
It was delineated a couple of years ago, I think.
Couple of years ago?
If it's to your advantage, yeah. I can let you know.
My other question had to do with future property lines. Are they planning on subdividing this property? Is that the...
In the future, we want to keep that option open, and I think the intent here to show that line is that all of the work that would be approved under this order of conditions would fall in that property if we were to subdivide it. But right now, there's no subdivision proposal before you.
I was hoping that part of the intent might have been to put an easement on some of that property.
We're considering doing something like that on the back piece. We haven't done anything like that at this point.
Todd?
You done?
Yeah.
This line that's on here, the Floodplain and Watershed Protection District?
Yes.
Whose line is that?
It's a town of Scituate zoning line, and it follows the elevation 90 contour. So that's why you see that shown on there. You're not allowed to do any filling within that zone.
That's that zone. I saw that on the map. The whole property is in the Water Resource Protection District.
Correct.
The whole area. When I was out there, I kind of thought we wouldn't need to ask for someone to verify the lines, but when I was out there today by Wetland Flag 6, there was a large, like, area of cinnamon ferns that I thought were an indicator species, and the flag was well beyond them back.
Sure.
And it's not a very densely treed site.
No.
So when I looked up, I'm like, well, there's not really any trees here, and all that's on the ground was cinnamon ferns. I know you're out of the 50, so I mean, that like 10 feet little bump out isn't really going to change this, but in terms of where it goes, we do have a responsibility to look out for Cohasset's drinking water interests, just like we hope Norwell will look out for ours, because, so I mean, I think it has to be up to the commission whether or not we need another outside consultant or not. Other than that, everything is...
I understand with the void in the agent not necessarily going out and walking the lines and everything. I understand that.
Richard?
No additional questions.
Well, I mean, certainly in a larger scale project, we'd look to have somebody go out and verify them if we couldn't get the agent to do it. So I guess if you were to find that there was a delineation done and they were matched pretty closely, mm-hmm. personally I'd be willing to work with that. But if that's not the case, then we should get somebody to confirm that.
Okay. Mostly because we don't have an agent. I mean, if we had an agent, it would be a lot different.
Absolutely. I mean, I can certainly do some research and see if I can pull a line or see if the line was surveyed when it was flagged. Yeah. Maybe I can find remnants of old flags that were on. I don't know.
Well, do one of the other. One of the other.
Certainly take a look. And, yeah, if I don't see them, report back, and we can look into a consultant if I can find anything.
I think it's something that could be done fairly quickly. It's not a tough one, I don't think, and it could be done pretty reasonably.
Okay.
Your question about whether a piece, you know, whether more mitigation to ask for some restriction or whatever. Personally, I think that would come if they came back to divide it. I mean, right now you've got a pretty big lot with one house on it.
Yeah, but there's a, it's a small area which can be built on.
Well, how much upland do you, have you calculated there?
Yeah, there's 99,000 square feet of upland on the site.
It's over 2 acres.
Well, then they should be able to pull it back out of the 100, but I'm really thinking in concept as much as anything else.
I guess personally, I'd leave that open for
something
if they came back and said, you know, we'd like to get another lot. Then you've increased that density, and then we could talk about...
Okay.
That would be my opinion. I mean, I'm one of five here tonight, so... I just personally feel that to have one house on that much land is pretty reasonable. If they were in here...
Well, that's, yeah, I don't disagree with that. But looking at the at that whole area and thinking back to some of the other issues that we've had out there over time. There was a piece of property to the east of this that has a very long, long driveway that hasn't been used. I can't remember. I don't even know the name of that person.
Litchfield? It's way out back.
Could have been.
Yeah.
And then we had the piece that came in off Summer Street. Remember that?
Right.
And all of that fed into this area, and so I'm just concerned about it as much as anything.
No, I think it's worth protecting, and certainly the piece that was off Summer Street, we put some standards on because they were trying to work in the wetlands.
Yeah. No.
I just and if we're going to have a limit of work. To me, it's how much, what's the total acreage of this lot?
3.29.
Yeah.
It's a big so if they were coming in and saying we want three houses here, it'd be a total different deal.
No question.
In my mind.
No question.
But
what about fencing it? Fencing the back.
At least the bushes need to
further
be
delineated.
Right along the edge of the 50-foot.
Yeah, so buffer. Yeah,
either split rail fence or. Shrubs would be fine.
I'd be inclined to go with plants rather than
plant
row.
Does that make sense?
No, it's in the bylaw. It says that every project should have it.
Yeah. I'd be happy with something like that.
Okay. Certainly add that.
All right, so why don't you see if you can find that, and if not, we'll have to get Dr. Carroll and get a somebody out there to confirm that wetlands line. All right. Do you think that can happen in a couple weeks?
Yeah, I would say so. Yeah, I'll try to research this on the next day or two.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry, in the audience?
I just want to say, I'll help Greg. I think I have that plan. And the board would probably be happy to know that one of your consultants that actually did it. I would assume you'd accept the line.
Okay.
So the 17th will work for you?
Yeah, sounds like it will.
All right. So I'll make a motion to continue Anthony at Thomas Clapp Road, the new build, until December 17th at 7:10 p.m.
Second.
Favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Greg, did you... Have you gotten anywhere with Crosby?
Yeah, I'm moving forward with the land court.
Okay.
Subdivision piece there.
Great.
Signed off on that.
Okay.
So.
Great. Good. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is 2 weeks, and then I'm going to ruin that again. Say the last name.
Castro.
188 Central Ave, porch addition, reset riprap boulders, continued.
Good evening, folks. Once again, my name is Gary Walcott. I work for Grady Consulting, and we're representing the homeowner Susan DeCastro in this matter. If you recall from the meeting last time, what the commission was concerned about was some more details on the wall and what exactly was, well, not the wall, the pile of stones I'm going to actually call it today. So what I've done to change the plan is I've added an existing profile that sort of shows the existing boulders in a bit of a jumble as they appear. And a proposed pile that shows them in a somewhat neater fashion with some smaller stones filling voids in between them to make it as tight as possible. And also a front view of it here with zero here being the left property line if you're facing it from the beach, and 50 being the right property line if you're facing it from the beach. As you can see, it does extend onto the neighbor's property. What we're proposing is to sort of blend and match into that there. We have more to secure from the abutter on the right if you're looking at it from the beach. A letter from them saying that they really don't have any problem with the project, that they realize that we'll be blending in with theirs, and any work that's done or affects their part of the wall, that the DeCastros are taking the responsibility to make that all fit together. At Todd's suggestion, he did ask me to notify the two abutters, one on each side. We've been unable to secure any communication with the abutter on the left at this point.
From the ocean, with the ocean?
Yeah, if you're the one on the left, I mean, as you can see, that abutter there, there's a little bit of a spill over here that goes right up to their boulder wall there. What this indicates here, with this zero being the property line, is that anything that's off the property is going to be pulled back and restacked on the existing boulders that are on the applicant's property. At this point, I'm suggesting that we made our effort to notify them. We did notify them by certified mail prior to the meeting. They've had two opportunities to come. So I think our notice to the abutters has been sufficient. And what I really wanted to reiterate tonight is that this isn't any kind of structural wall. It's not poured concrete or anything like that. It's a pile of big stones that they sort of want to restack a little neater, fill in some voids, and go. And additionally to that, I've also added in a line here indicating where the work will occur and where they can stockpile the boulders on site. And also that the access to the site will be across the beach via Atlantic and Seaview. Are there any questions?
Richard? Am I to take it that on the left, the abutter that you have not been able to contact, that those rocks were moved off, they were originally there and they moved off, and you're just pulling them back?
I don't know for sure, but I mean, it sort of appears that it's sort of crumbled away. I mean, our intention is to keep it all on the applicant's property and stack them in a neater fashion. Mm-hmm. There will be a gap between the walls there, but theirs doesn't extend to their property line. We'd like to just keep all of ours on that property. Or if you'd prefer that we leave some going over there and attaching to theirs. Well, it's off of the property, so I'd rather just...
We're not going to tell you that you can work on their property
right.
at all.
That's why I'm suggesting that we get it all off and keep it on our own property.
But that's something you need to work out.
Right. It might be better for them if we could get in touch with them to suggest that, but for now, I'm proposing that it's all on our property.
Okay.
Thank you.
Todd?
Thanks for getting the letters.
We did our best. I mean, I would like to have gotten the second one as well, but you're welcome.
I wasn't trying to be a jerk. I want you to know that. And I'm not trying to, like, stop you guys from protecting your house. I think that kind of, I might have come across the wrong way at the last hearing.
No, don't worry about it.
it's driving onto the beach with heavy equipment.
Yep.
And messing with the seawall that stretches for six houses, a revetment.
Right.
It's technically a revetment for six houses is kind of a big deal.
Right.
Especially on this piece of property. Yeah, we, I mean, and it's.
Well, any work that's done by the town with revetments and things, there's usually a whole list of procedures and work and things like that. So in, if we look at it in that regard, this is pretty reasonable to allow this to go forward.
Oh, yeah, no, definitely. In terms of the wall, yeah, yeah, I mean.
So I wouldn't be too.
Honestly, the only real issue I have is that the property's in three areas, the riverfront, it's in the 100-foot buffer to a salt marsh, and it's in a velocity zone. So adding to the house, to me, is a, I'm not in favor of it without some form of mitigation in terms of you're putting a, an enclosed structure on the front of the house, on the riverside of the house, mm-hmm. within 100 feet to the river, which in the actual wetlands.
I don't believe that that enclosed part of it is within the.
It seems like it. If you look at the line that you have there, it's.
I'm just, you're right. The front,
I mean,
the front
it's a tiny bit.
Right,
I know,
right.
It's tiny. Yep. But the whole property, the land that it sits on is not even 300 feet wide.
Correct.
And it's sinking into the ocean on one side and has a rising river on the other side. So it's a
big deal.
A big deal. I mean, I don't want to be like so nitpicky, but I think that the driveway runs at a pretty good slope down to the river. And I think that in, this is me and my one vote, I think for adding the additions and the decks, that we don't have any information on what they're supported by, how many piles, if there's going to be any piles replaced on the rear deck, even though it's an in-kind replacement, we don't know any of that stuff on this plan. Mm-hmm. So I would rather see, if we're just going to have less information, than that the commission says no without some form of mitigation. Either you cut out an equal part or a 2-to-1 part of the driveway at the very bottom and put in some sort of gravel or something to let the, when the ocean does come over this property and runs down the driveway and into across the street to the salt marsh, mm-hmm. that it slows it down.
There is a small amount of, I don't know if you agree that it qualifies as mitigation, but there is an area here where we are putting that enclosed storage area, enclosed or three season porch above in storage, that we are ripping up a patio in that area. I mean, it's minor.
But it's a pervious. It's pervious because it's blocks.
Some of
so
it is concrete.
No, there's poured concrete in that area too. The whole walkway going up and up the side, that's all being removed.
So there is some.
Because in the, see, I mean, that's like, these pictures that are on here are, it looks like a completely different house to me. And it still looks like a lot of concrete up there in the front that's not changing. And in terms of.
If you, basically, to try to help you out with that part of the house, if you look at, like, this corner, the rear corner, and this one here, those are all, I mean, they're in the same area as these three corners right here. And this overhang here is pretty similar to what they're proposing here. It's still two stories in front. It does, this wall on the back is going to come up a little bit, but it's really, it's not a huge difference than what it is out there now.
I kind of think that's how the whole thing is going. It's all just a little bit underneath what would be substantial enough to either trigger elevation or more mitigation. I mean, it just all seems like just a little bit here, a little bit there. Don't worry about it. We're just going to drive onto the beach here. And that's honestly, that makes me nervous, because when people say, don't worry about it, that's when I'm like,
that's when you're worried.
Okay. It's like, you know, the car salesman. Yeah, it's fine. It checked out.
So what you would like to see is removal of the asphalt driveway. It would be go a good distance for you.
That would be huge, and it would make a big difference.
We're going to go through the members.
It would make
and
a big difference for the property,
too. You have to state your name and all that stuff, but first we're going to work through here.
For the resource across the street, it would make a huge difference.
Okay. Tony?
go through what you currently are going to be taking up from a pervious standpoint.
It's really what's underneath where we're proposing this new three-season porch.
The existing block patio, is that?
Correct. That's the only area, well, it's the only pervious material in the area that we're proposing new work. I understand that some of the members feel that removing pervious areas and areas where we're not proposing work might be a way to go. At this time, we're proposing to remove pervious areas where we're proposing new work.
And what are you going to put down there after you take up the patio?
It's going to be sonotubes holding up.
The raised, and what will be underneath that?
Stone.
Crushed stone.
Yeah.
So it's still technically going to be impervious because it's a roof and it's an enclosed structure. It's not going to have water infiltrating into the ground.
Not from directly overhead.
Sorry, Tony, excuse me.
That's where we're going on this. And that's the only area, because I agree with Todd. I think it's an important issue.
What I'm having difficulty with is that we're not creating any areas. We're not asking to do any work that creates new areas of impervious material. I understand that we're in resource areas, but I don't think that what we're proposing is any kind of change at all from what's existing on the site.
Can I come up for a second?
Go ahead.
No, we're going to go through and then...
I just want to comment on the plan for him.
Well,
I don't think he understands
it. Just hold your
thought.
All right. Hold your
thought. Okay. Anything else, Mr. Jones?
No, that's my issue.
Okay.
We'll discuss it later, mm-hmm. further.
Sure. No questions.
Okay.
Paul?
I am Paul Armstrong, the contractor on the job. There is more concrete area coming out. This whole stairway is coming out, and the concrete walkway up the side is being removed. There's a lot of poured concrete where the stairs go up here. That's all coming out in this area in here.
Paul, can you point at the photo on the left and say what's coming out?
Yes. Everything here where this railing system is and this concrete patio all the way up to the side rail, these concrete stairs are coming out.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was under a misapprehension of that part.
No, that's all being removed all the way up the side.
I thought that's what
you said. There's a concrete walkway up the side, and what we're proposing to do is to keep all the dune grasses here so we're elevated off the ground and get rid of the concrete walkway going up the side.
Okay.
So this way, everything is traveled through the deck areas. And just also, the catch basin at the very base of the driveway. And I just got to say, if that gets removed, that catch basin is owned by the town. It's going to fill up the material all the time. And if anything, what we can do to mitigate for the roof area, I can put a infiltrated drain system underneath that porch and put the downspouts into it to compensate for the roof runoff.
Is there anything at the base of the driveway that slows? Because, I mean, if the cobble comes down, then it could...
No, it's just where the grades are. It's more of a level area at the base, and everything just goes into that catch basin.
You can see where the grading... When you see a dashed line like this...
That's where
go
it goes
straight across the driveway. See how it comes up from the street to it, and then goes straight across the driveway, and then back down towards the street? That's indicative of a slope in that direction.
Paul, I got to tell you, more like a door than a window. For these guys over here.
A what?
You're more like a door than a window.
Sorry, guys.
it keeps us focused on the left side of the.
But all the architects, the house, the only add-ons to the house is this porch area and the front deck. Everything else is we're just tweaking some of the roof lines. We're not. The only square footage of the house we're adding is just this porch area.
So can I ask a question?
Sure.
I'm glad we're going through this because it's helpful. We didn't know this from the first hearing. So on the side, you're going to go around the house here. How are you going to get?
We're talking now.
So if you're looking at
there's a walkway going down the side that's proposed. Correct, right here.
Yeah. So when you was
there's a concrete walkway that's there right now.
You just can't see it.
That's correct. I'd have to take a down picture, but it's. It's actually shown right there.
Push right in here.
Yeah.
So the beach grass is just growing out of it or over it or how?
No, it's buried inside it. It's down inside.
So it's just like.
Yes, correct. The grass is, and the whole thing is on the.
You can almost, you can kind of see it right on the side of this picture here.
Is that even necessary to take it out if the beach grass is growing over it so well?
No, this is where we're going to replant that whole area. And the whole thing, as I explained to the owners, all the front here where the beach roses are and everything, I suggest we leave all those nice beach cobbles there. And I said, we need that as a splash zone. That's why the house has been there all these years and never been hit. I mean, everything around has been destroyed, but.
God willing.
Yeah, but it's just, it's worked, so.
Because in, I mean.
We're just trying to keep it simple and.
Right. I know, that's.
Yeah.
But it's not that simple, because like when you go over here, then you're going to dig on the side and dig up, and then you're going to have to replant that area.
Correct.
But there's, we don't have any, we didn't know that until now.
Yeah.
That's why.
That was the whole suggestion of getting this, replace the existing deck, get rid of the concrete walkway, the patio that's all the way out here that comes all the way to the edge of the driveway, and to do a small walkway down the side so it's elevated so the water has an area to wash and infiltrate.
There's been a little, obviously there's been a little bit of miscommunication on our side, for which I apologize. I wasn't aware of some of these details.
Because when you look at these pictures, it looks like.
Yeah, it looks different, yeah.
You guys are like going to town here. It looks like, it really does in terms of.
Like this overhang, this garrison overhang's become a little false roof line. Just for architectural details. It makes the house look totally different.
It does, yeah. Yeah. It makes it look like you're putting a whole second floor on it.
No, there, I mean, there is a second floor now. It's just, it's.
It's just, yeah, just changing the route, the way angle, the roof pitch is.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're just changing the roof pitch.
So what's going to be on the ground when you take all this stuff up?
Crushed stone.
Crushed stone.
Yes.
It's all going to be crushed.
Everything stone. Underneath all the new areas is all going to be crushed stone.
Okay. Much happier.
Yeah.
So.
Me too.
I hate to say it, but we kind of, we need a planting plan too. I hate to do that to you, but I mean.
But we can,
you,
we can
we
make
know,
a,
we do.
We can make a planting plan part of the conditions.
Yes. Yeah. But it should, we should, because, I mean, you telling us that here.
No, I understand.
You could, know. If you could make. You know, a potential approval contingent upon it. I can get you a plan in the next couple of days. At the next meeting, you can.
Well, we'll have it. We'll make it part of our orders that there's a
whatever
approved
you
planting plan.
Yep. You know, wherever there's dune grasses, we'll put dune grasses back, and so on and so forth.
Okay. And we'll add some. And you'll want to just make sure you mention the crushed stone as well.
Yep.
Or be mentioned.
And a statement as to what you were talking about. Taking the
roof drains.
Yeah, that's easy.
Planting
that's
them on the
that's always used to be on the standard orders anyways. All the homes we did down there, we always have to put them on the drain.
So sometimes we have a habit of overlooking things like that, which is not good. So we're not.
If you, in the meantime, have a chance to put that together and shoot it to us, it'll we'll
I
get
could.
That.
I could do that for you
do
tomorrow.
That. Okay. Do that, and then we'll make it part of the orders.
Okay.
All right?
Sure.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
I hope you don't think I was like making assumptions
today.
About you. It seems that way, but
no.
They're tough. They can handle.
All right, good.
Don't worry.
I was telling him before. I was like, you know, sometimes there's give and take and disagreement, but as long as everybody realizes it's not personal, everybody's just doing their job. If I see you in the hallway, I'm not gonna punch you.
That's good. Say, I went to the gym today.
In the face.
Yeah.
Unless you're
enhancing. Man. Thank you.
So can we have a motion to close?
To close, I think, yeah.
All right. Make a motion to close Towig Nicastro at 188 Central Avenue.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'll bring him with you next time.
I'm not going to go there.
We all have our crosses to bear. No?
I couldn't see the plan.
Oh, God.
Anybody ever tell you that when you stand in front of something? You
oh,
think
absolutely. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I tell my kids that, and they're standing in front of the TV. They don't get it.
Yeah.
They haven't figured it out yet.
No.
Yeah. All right, what else do we have?
McSherry Brothers requested a continuance.
By how much longer?
Until the next meeting.
Okay. Have a motion?
Make a motion to continue McSherry Brothers Lot 1 and 2, 218 First Parish Road, to December 17th at 7:20 PM.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
What do we got? How much stuff do we have then?
Oh, this is a pretty good meeting, yeah.
Okay.
Don't you want to continue to 6:30, maybe?
We already have somebody at 6:30.
We do?
Yeah, we have Bartlett Fields at 6:30.
We had a couple from the last meeting.
We have 6:30, 6:40, 6:50, 6:55, 7, 7:10, and 7:20 now.
What's the date on that?
17th.
December 17th.
Frank, stick that there.
Why don't we put them in at like 6:55?
There's already somebody at 6:55. Bylaw only? That's that new one, that's what we just got today.
We haven't gotten anything back from,
We can make it 7:15.
For the Clap Road, Booth Hill, yeah, from one of the consultants, so I don't even know if that. And a proposal I'm talking about, they wanted two or three proposals.
For?
We have one.
Bartlett's Field?
Yeah. We haven't gotten a second.
So make them, then make McSherry 6:25 or something like that.
All right, so McSherry Brothers.
I'm getting close to time, I need to do some Christmas shopping by then.
218 First Parish Road, continued to December 17th at 6:25.
Okay. Second?
Second.
Oh, second.
Favor?
All right.
Thank you. Order conditions for Cole Kane, 24 and 26 Wade Street, septic repair. Anybody have a chance to look at that?
I don't know, it's fine, it's standard.
I think it's fine, I think it's.
It's just a standard.
It's an improvement.
Okay.
I have no problems with it.
Yeah, it's set.
So we're pretty simple.
Any motion for that?
Yeah, a motion to approve the orders as written.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Rosemary?
When you have a chance, would you take a moment to expand on the issue of the overwash and deposits of the mulch? Because we need more answers than.
Well, you brought those pictures the other night, right? And I went in and spoke to the DPW about what happened there. We discussed where some of that was pushed back. I guess there was some, a little bit of misunderstanding with some of the equipment operators. We have a set of orders for them to be able to push things back, but not go back that far. So, but you were aware, we don't have an agent right now to do that. So really, until we get somebody on board that can go down and take a look at that and decide if we want to have some material moved or what other action we want to take. It's really, I'm not sure what else we'll do with it at this point.
If another storm comes along before there is an agent on board, is anyone going to be watching to make sure nothing gets pushed into the marsh?
Think that you should ask the selectmen that question.
Or maybe the state.
Or whatever, that's fine.
Thank you.
I mean, we're sort of limited to what we can do then. I brought that up with them and brought it to their attention. And so hopefully we'll have someone that can help us with some of that, but. All right?
Thank you.
Thank you.
We did get a letter from Hal.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want me to read that?
Yeah.
It's kind of specific, actually.
Email it to Rosemary.
You want me to read it, you can read it.
Should I put my glasses on?
Number six.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
All right, so DPW re Central Ave Emergency Cleanup, 11/6/12. DPW was unable to open street with own equipment, hired Landers endeavored to move debris to the seaward side, 2.5 feet of the seawater trap on the road. The sea threw material into the marsh, and ocean couldn't follow its normal route into the South River. Opened a channel into the marsh, but at no time did the dozer cut into the marsh grass or attempt to push more debris further into the marshes. Piles of sand and stone staying until spring.
It's just not true.
Don't shoot me, I'm just the messenger.
I understand that.
Did you guys find the emergency order of conditions that were written for DPW on the streets?
No, we haven't.
Have you determined if they're in violation or not?
We don't have an agent, Steve, so.
But I mean, any?
No, I think we're gonna wait till an agent makes that decision. Or the state, I don't care.
Yeah, you have a copy of that letter, or is it?
Was it an email?
I think it was an email. Oh, no, maybe it was put on my chair. Sure, I'll get one.
Thank you.
Unless anybody else wants to take it up, that's the way I believe we should pursue that.
We need an agent.
It sure looked as though they were pushing things into the marsh from the pictures that we saw.
They did.
Unfortunately, I'm not going to be around to...
Well, I just don't think it's wise for volunteer members to act on that piece. I personally think...
Well, to act, but maybe we could... do some work around the edges.
Well,
I don't know.
I don't feel comfortable giving somebody direction as to how they want to correct it or move it. Or
oh, I agree with that. I agree with that.
We're better off to go.
Just waiting.
I was looking, I assume that everyone would agree that none of that should have been pushed into the marsh. Beyond that, it's not your responsibility to make sure that it was done, or I would assume, or that something is done now, as long as the powers that be have been reminded.
And that was the response, and that's the response that we got. I took the photos that you gave me and discussed it with them, and that's the response. But I think if we had an agent that could go out and deal with that, that would be appropriate. But hopefully that's a situation that's remedied, and then we'll have a few things that we've got to address, and that would be one of them.
Right.
Can we go to Edward Foster Road?
Sure.
Because I was out there, and I'm not sure that I understand the issue that we've got.
I didn't get a chance to see it.
I just saw the pictures.
But,
I actually didn't drive out there because the photographs are pretty clear. I mean, the fence is right next to the salt marsh. And if you look on the pectometry thing that we have in the office, it's definitely within 50 feet of...
Okay.
But I mean, you go down and I think it's 102 Edward Foster Road and 106. They both have big fences all around the property.
I'm not even sure the fence is really an impact to the resource. I can't think of one other than that when they dug, they put in cement footings to the fence. But I mean, otherwise, they cleaned it up. They're done. I think a neighbor called.
Oh, is that what happened?
Yeah.
Is that how it came about?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not. I can't think of anything that it's other than when they actually did it. They probably should have gotten an RDA just because they were digging right next to the marsh.
I don't know why we were approving fences down closer to the water on the other side. Anyway, I mean, you know, on the 100s. I know it doesn't relate to this, but you know. You sort of opened a can of worms, I think.
Yeah, I mean, it's up to the commission if we want to pursue it, if we want to send them a letter, if we want to have them for a show cause hearing, or...
Well, I'm going to try to take a look myself, because I just haven't had a chance to get there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to go look.
Good, yep, yep.
So, we had 147 Hollitt Street, and on the transition report from the agent, it was asked that we go out and verify where the fence and the posts were put for their, they had the wetland delineated, and then they were supposed to put a fence at the 50-foot. So I went out and I measured it, and there is a fence. I'm not really sure it's what you guys would think of when we said put a fence. It's two pieces of picket fence, like 8-foot sections of picket fence, maybe even 6-foot sections, and they use tomato stakes to hold them in place, and they're just kind of there, and they're really not actually 50 feet from the flag.
We're talking about a one-year fence.
And it's also placed directionally so that you can still access the area.
All right.
I don't...
So it's pretty much useless.
It is, and I don't even...
So
I mean, when
wanna...
they delineated it, they only delineated one tiny area. The whole thing should have been delineated because there's like, when I walked through the yard, it was like a swamp. I mean, it was spongy. So I'm thinking all those reeds are probably, I honestly don't want anything to do with it. I just don't. I mean, that if you go over there and look at what the neighbors are doing two or three doors down in the actual wetland, the stuff they're dumping, that's kind of more of a big deal than this guy running his lawnmower over there. They're all dumping back in that back corner by the railroad tracks. There's all kinds of stuff back there. Leaf piles, piles of debris. I just don't want, I mean, I'm not personally chasing that around. It's not my responsibility. They're my neighbors. I mean, well, not direct neighbors, but we live in Scituate. I just thought you guys should know that. I tried to get us, because that's what we told them to do, and so I tried to make sure that that's what they did, and I'm not sure they did what we had intended they were going to do.
Well, I think that's one that we should just leave to be readdressed.
Fair enough.
At some point.
All right. We address the whole area. I mean, if every house is doing the same thing, I mean, it's a little bit like having, you know, one person...
Yeah, well, he's mowing. I don't know that the guy who was mowing is the one who was dumping, but there was definitely fresh branches from a tree that looked like it was in his yard back in the
okay.
If we only had an agent.
All right, so let's just table this one.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
So you know.
Okay. All right.
Fine with me.
Anybody else?
We approve. Do the minutes.
Sure. Do we have any to do tonight?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
October 22nd. Oh, I read it. It was fine with me.
I have a motion to approve the minutes of October 22nd, 2012.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay.
I think that's it.
That's good.
Yeah, make a motion to close.
Jaron?
Close what?
Oh, sorry. You do that?
Yeah. No, you're fine. It's fine. Promotion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Sorry, I just wanted to get out of here.
No.
This is like a land speed record, I think.